Barakatha Yahweh.
Barakatha
Yahweh
Shai.
Double honor to the elders, the apostles of GMS, the honors and blessings to the elect throughout the four corners of the earth that's pushing this truth. The name of this lesson is going to be entitled Tainos Spoke Hebrew. And when you do your research, you find out the people that were called Tainos are the people that lived in the Caribbean islands, all right? Cuba, Hispaniola, Puerto Rico, the West Indian Islands, all right? The people that lived on those islands were Tainos, all right? They were of Taino Indian descent, also known as the Arawak Indians. You know, Taino was a certain tribe of the Arawak Indians, okay? And they're Israelites, okay? Because the people of Taino Indian descent are you people of the island of Puerto Rico. Like, we just named the islands, you know, you so-called Puerto Ricans, you so-called Cubans, so-called Dominicans, all right? You're of Taino Indian descent, okay? Now, you know, I used to just speak about the Tainos that lived on the island of Puerto Rico, but basically you had Tainos on all these different islands, all right? We have a map here, all right? You have Hispaniola, you have Cuba, Hispaniola, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, Trinidad, all right? You had Tainos on all these different islands, all right? You know, but who lived there today? Who are there today? You know, you people that's calling yourselves Cubans, people that's calling yourselves Dominicans on Hispaniola, all right, which is the Dominican Republic in Haiti today. All right, and you people on the island of Puerto Rico, you're descendants of the Tainos, okay? All right, so, all right, you got something to say,
bro? Yeah, I was just going to say, porque la gente allí son los indios Tainos originales, okay? Y ese es su, es como le, antes de la conquista. So pretty much before the conquest, those are who those people were. The original Taino Indians. And that's where they get the whole Spanish language from that they speak now. But before that, they were speaking Hebrew.
Yep. And that's exactly what we're about to get into. All right. Now, and you have the island of Jamaica, and they have Trinidad there. All right. You were on those islands too. But, you know, you have... you know, the southern kingdom of Israel, all right, which were the, you know, the tribe of Benjamin, you know. I mean, Judah went to, you know, North America. Well, basically, you know, you had Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, you know. They brought us from the west coast of Africa, and, you know, they brought a lot of us to the islands, you know. But for the most part, Judah went to North America, you know, but you had Benjamin, you know, they got brought to the West Indian Islands, all right, you know, which would be Jamaica and Trinidad, you know. But who were there first, you know? The Tainos, all right, and we have pictures of them here, you know. That's you today, because these are so-called Dominican women, man, all right? So you have a lot of our people. A lot of you so-called Dominicans, so-called Puerto Ricans, so-called Cubans, you know that you're descendants of these people, all right? But without further ado, we're going to get into the information, because that's the main thing. Now, we had this book, Christopher Columbus and the Participation of the Jews in the Spanish and Portuguese Discoveries by M. Kaeserling, all right? And we're just going to get right to it, okay? Because you had a man by the name of Luis de Torres, okay? Luis de Torres, and he was used as an interpreter for Christopher Columbus, all right? And this is on page 95, okay? The water out. Luis de Torres, the first European who discovered the use of tobacco, was also the first person of Jewish stock who settled in Cuba, okay? Now, I'm going to skip down because, you know, they said all I need to say. That's all we needed. All right. And it says, in Cuba, Hispaniola, and the other islands which he discovered, Columbus found natives who had their caciques, which means chiefs, and their own language and traditions. To what race did these aborigines of America belong? Several writers have asserted and have displayed much learning in attempting to prove that the aborigines were descendants of the Jews. So, in other words, they were Israelites. But you heard what they said. Luis de Torres, he was the first person of Jewish stock who settled in Cuba, because Columbus specifically brought him as an interpreter, okay? And actually, we have a document that talks about that. Well, this is off of Wikipedia, all right? Luis de Torres died 1493. You can read this on your own, but basically it says his name in Hebrew. Joseph, son of Levi the Hebrew, was Christopher Columbus's interpreter on his first voyage and the first person of Jewish origin to settle in America. All right. And as you read on, it says that he had knowledge of Hebrew, so he spoke different languages. So he was specifically brought as an interpreter. Okay. And we have this here. All right. It's a page off the internet, you know, that I found on Taino. It says Taino gold, because the conquistadors and the Spaniards, when they came to the Americas, they came for gold, okay? And that's what they were trying to get. That's what they were trying to extract from the Tainos, all right? But I'm going to jump down to the third paragraph. You know, it speaks about the Taino people and the Taino language, you see. But the third paragraph, it says, the official interpreter for Columbus's fleet was Luis de Torres, who was a converted Jew. Really, when you read on this guy, you find out that he was an Israelite, okay? Because you had Jews in Spain and in Portugal. We knew that we were the Jews, you know, but a lot of us, we were forced to convert to Roman Catholicism. Torres was chosen as a fleet interpreter because he spoke Hebrew and Arabic. For some reason, would enable him to communicate with the Chinese. Apparently, Torres was unable to converse with the Taino in Hebrew, so another course of action was deemed necessary. But the question should arise, why would he try to speak to the Taino in Hebrew? Why would he try to do that? Because they knew that they were the Israelites. Now, we're going to go back to this book here, all right, because, you know, the information speaks for itself. That's why we're focusing the camera on the information, all right? All right, give me a second here. All right, why don't you speak for a minute?
Yeah, start off with Second Ezra.
All right. Yeah, you get the scripture.
All right, Second Ezra 13:39. And whereas thou sawest that he gathered another peaceable multitude unto him, those are the 10 tribes which will carry away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Osea the king, whom Shalmaneser the king of Assyria led away captive.
Yep, so that's it. You know, the Israelites came to the Americas, man. All right? This is that country they came to whenever mankind dwelt.
Right.
All right? North, Central, and South America, along with the islands, all right? All right, now, we're still in the book, Christopher Columbus and the Participation of the Jews in the Spanish and Portuguese Discoveries. We're on page 97, which really, you can read all of this, man. It's all good, but we just want to hit the point, all right? It is not improbable that the Jews who were driven from Nineveh by Shalmaneser wandered into uninhabited regions. He just read that, you know? Hey, come on, man. According to Herrera, the Indians cherished the tradition that Yucatan had been settled by tribes from the Orient. The Orient means east. So Yucatan, who's in the land of Yucatan? Yucatan is in Mexico. So you people that call yourself Mexicans are Israelites, all right? Several writers give the exact route by which the Jews traveled until they settled in Cuba. You see that? And that's the main point we want to harp on how you people that call yourselves Cubans, are Israelites, all right, because you're of Taino-Indian descent. Now, I'm just going to read the highlighted part. Really, all of this is good, but we want to hit the point, okay? Rodin's chief argument in support of his view is the language of the Indians in Hispaniola, Cuba, Jamaica, and the adjoining islands. Right, which were the islands that we showed you. So all these islands, that's what they're talking about. All right? That's what he's talking about, Rodin. He contends that it has many resemblances to Hebrew. In fact, he even calls it corrupt Hebrew. All right? So there you have it. And to go further, he asserts that such names as Cuba and Haiti are Hebrew, and that they were first applied by the earliest caciques, the chiefs or leaders. So that's it. So he says that the names Cuba and Haiti are Hebrew. All right, and we're going to show you that. That's it, brother, with the book. All right. But we're going to show you this in the information that we have. All right. Now, no, this is off of Wikipedia about the Taino. And we'll read a little bit of the first paragraph. The Taino were an Arawak people who were one of the major indigenous peoples of the Caribbean at the time of European contact in the late 15th century. They were the principal inhabitants of most of Cuba, Jamaica, Hispaniola, presently Haiti and the Dominican Republic, and Puerto Rico and the greater Antilles, the northern lesser Antilles and the Bahamas, where they were known as the Lucayans, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. They spoke the Taino language, one of the Arawakan languages. Okay, and so you read about where they were inhabited and who they are, okay? And the Europeans, they came in contact with them first because the island of Hispaniola was the first place that Columbus arrived to. All right. And it says it here. At the time of Columbus's arrival in 1492, there were five Taino chiefdoms and territories on Hispaniola, modern-day Dominican Republic and Haiti. Okay. And basically, we're going to show you the name Cuba. Cuba is a Hebrew word. So that's, you know, I'm going to read a little bit of this, but that's really the point, all right? It says, each led by a principal cacique chieftain to whom tribute was paid. Aiete, land of high mountains, was the indigenous Taino name for the mountainous side of the island of Hispaniola, which has kept this name as it is used as the Haitian Creole form of Haiti. So Aiete means land of high mountains, but that goes back to the Hebrew, but now it's called Haiti. All right. And this is the point that we want to get. All right. So this is the fifth paragraph. All right. Well, fourth paragraph. All right. The end of it. Okay, it says, the name Cuba comes from the Taino language. However, the exact meaning of the name is unclear, but it may be translated either as where fertile land is abundant, Cubao, or great place, Cuabana, or Coabana. So it means where fertile land is abundant or great place. All right, so let's find out how you say it in Hebrew. All right, so the way you say Cuba in Hebrew is Kwawaba. All right, well, you know, the fake Jews, man. You know how they'll, you know, try to say it. Kuba. Well, that's how people say it, Kuba. You know, but in Hebrew it's Kwawaba or it's Kwaba because we found it on Blue Letter. All right, it says Kwaba. You know, and it says, large vaulted tent or tent. Okay, but if you know anything about the scriptures, sometimes when it mentions a tent, that could actually mean land. All right, and as we have the encyclopedia here, the Golden Book Encyclopedia, all right, on page 381, you see Cuba, that's a large portion of land. All right? Yes, some saber.
Oh, yeah, the cuando decimos Cuba, es una palabra hebrea, significa un gran lugar, o como le. El hermano estaba diciendo un gran carpa, which it basically means a large man or a large land or a large tent.
Yep. Yeah. And you see, and it's, you know, it's great for, it's known for natural resources, cocoa, beans, sugar, tobacco, there's a lot of cattle there, so, you know, dairy, coffee, fruit, manganese, iron, chromite. You know, but this is the largest island in the Western Hemisphere, okay? But, you know, the way you say it in the Hebrew is Kwaba or Kwawaba, and it means large vaulted tent, all right? And, I mean, like we said, the information speaks for itself, and we have the definition of tent or the meaning of tent, you know, in the Bible, and it gives you scriptures there. Genesis 9:21, Genesis 9:27. This word is used also of a dwelling or habitation. You know, so you dwell and you can inhabit a land. You know, so you know that's what that means. All right. Now the Taino people themselves. All right. We have the list of Tainos off of Wikipedia. Excuse me, and. You know, we read about, you know, who they are, you know, Columbus came in contact with them. But who are the Tainos and what does the word Taino mean? All right, so we're gonna go right here. The Tainos, Taino means good people. Unlike the Caribs, who practiced regular raids on other groups, were peaceful seafaring people and distant relatives of the Arawak people of South America. So... The name Taino, it means good people. And who are the good people? The good people are Israelites. So when you look at, you know, our people today, you see they're still trying to keep the Taino customs, but really you're Israelites, you know? That's really who you are. Okay, you're not really a Taino, you know, but you're descendants of those peoples. But the good people are the Israelites, all right? And... You know, we have reason to believe that the name Taino, you know, I looked into it a little bit, you know, you know, we believe that, well, we know that it goes back to the Hebrew, but it's possible, you know, you got the word Taino, you have the Hebrew word Tawab, which means good, you know, gives you the other definitions, better, happy, glad, but basically it means good. So you have the Hebrew word tawab, which means good, and the Hebrew word aim, which means nation or people. You know, so if you put those two words together, you know, it's just a thought. Tawab aim, you know, that, you know, it's similar to Taino, you know. And also, if you go into scriptures, different tribes, the way they spoke Hebrew, they had their different dialects. You know, one of those accounts is in the book of Judges, where you had the Israelites, I want to say, of Gilead. They were asking Ephraim to pronounce a certain word in Hebrew, and he couldn't pronounce it how, you know, the people of Gilead pronounced it, you know, so they knew that he was an Ephraimite, and they killed him, you know? So, yep. So that proves it, man, you know? But you're Israelites, man, okay? And some of these different chiefs, you know, you see some of the names here, all right? And they tell you they're on the island of Puerto Rico, etc. But, you know, they go back to the Hebrew. You know, these different names, these are names of chiefs that were on the island of Haiti, on the island of Hispaniola, on the island of Cuba, all right? And it's Hebrew, man, okay? You know, so this proves the point, you know, that's it, man. But you people that call yourselves, you know, Cubans, hey, we know that you're Israelites, man. And scripture says, how we're the salt of the earth. You know, you have different music. You know, they call it salsa. You know, well, you call it salsa. You know, and you got salsa, right? Hey, just think about it. Salsa, you eat, you know, like an actual sauce. You go to a so-called Latino restaurant. They give you sauce with the chips. It got flavor to it, man. So just like your music, okay? Your music has flavor, man. All right? So, I mean, that alone proves that you're Israelites, you know? That's it, man. Okay? That's good. All right, can you read your scripture out?
This is Psalms 85:11. The truth shall spring out of the earth, and the righteousness shall look down from heaven.
It says truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. So that's what you're seeing, man. You know, we're going into the information, all right, and proving that you're the Israelites, okay? And not just us, but starting with the apostles of GMS, okay? But two more bits of information I want to bring out, you know, really quick. I found this off the web, and it was comparing the Hebrew language to the Taino language, all right? And, you know, you can look this up. You know, the top says comparative philology, a comparison between Semitic and American languages with a map and illustrations by Arnold M. Leesburg. All right, so comparing different languages, and one of them being the American languages, the Taino, along with the North American Indian, the Mayans, the Aztecs. But it says Taino, Carib, Bana, Bauna, with Hebrew, Benayan, which means building. But really, the Taino is correct, not this Yiddish, Benayan or Banian, which means building. Bana is the right way to say it, the Taino way, because we looked it up, and that's how you say it, Bana. So the Taino way is right, not the so-called Jewish way, Bana. Okay, and you see it, and it means to build, rebuild. Okay, so they say it the right way. But see, the so-called white man, he'll never admit that he's wrong, because when you read further in this document, it says Dr. Leesburg's book is only another futile attempt to show a race relationship between the American Indians and the ancient Hebrews. So see, so they'll never admit the truth, man. Although he disclaims the theory that the American Aborigines were the 10 lost tribes, it is a pity that the author ever undertook such a task without first seeking competent philological advice. So the white man the devil, man. You know, y'all the devil. You know, you so-called white people watching this, you're the devil the Bible speaks of, and you'll never admit the truth, man. And this is the last information. It's called Taino mythology. And I brought this out before, but it hits the point on the head, all right? It says, Yahya. Yahya is the extreme vital principle, great creator of existence, ancestral agriculturalist, and innominate spirit. He killed his son, Yahya'el, whom he loved over all the things, before seeing usurped his majesty in danger and endanger his existence. So Yahya is supposed to be the Most High, and Hebrew is Yahweh. You know, that's how you say it. You know, you pass the paper, brother. All right. The way you say the Most High's name is Yahweh, which means he to be. It's how you write it in the Hebrew, Yahweh. And it says how he killed his son, Yahya'el, which the Most High did sacrifice his son for the elect of Israel. You know, it says Yahya'el, but the way you say it in the Hebrew is Yahweh Shai, which means he delivers, he saves. Okay. All right. So, I mean, that's it, man. Okay. And you have, you know, other Taino words. It all stems from the Hebrew. There you have it again. Yahya, the creator or great spirit. The term Yahya or Ayah Ayah means spirit of spirits. And that's the Most High. This might find that scripture real quick. Is it Hebrews? is it Hebrews, is it 12, Father Spirits? That's the Most High, man. You know? The Most High is the Spirit of Spirits, man. The scriptures even call him a consuming fire, you know? And that's why he's called the Most High. You know? Did you find it?
Yeah, you got it.
Okay.
Hebrews 12.
Yeah. It's like later on in the chapter. The Father of Spirits.
Hebrews 12 and 9. For more, we have had fathers of our flesh which corrected us, and we gave them
reverence.
Should not much rather be in subjection to the Father of the Spirit and live.
So the Father of Spirits, or Spirit of Spirits, is the Most High. And you see they're calling them Yahya. But you have to remember, they were here, you know, over 2,000 years, man. So they're not going to retain the name Yahweh. You know, they were here for a long time. Even the tribe of Gad, they were calling the Most High Yohiwa. You know? So they lost it, man. And you see, once again, they're calling the son of the Most High, Yahweh Shai, Yahyael, son of Yahya. So this is real, man. You know, and these were the ancestors of you so-called Puerto Ricans, so-called Dominicans, and Cubans today. All right? And it says, it's the last one, Yokahu, spirit of the sacred mountains of the Yucca, another of the names for the creator. So, Yokahu, that's similar to Yahweh, you know? But, I mean, that's it. I mean, we didn't beat it in the head, man. So, you know, you people that call yourselves Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Cubans, all right, you're Israelites, man. Okay? All right? So, with that, we'd like to say shalom.